Five adults face child abuse charges. One of them is under investigation for training children to commit school shooting.
Taos County has just dropped the charges against three of the five suspects, the judge saying he simply had no choice.
Remember that terrorist training camp in New Mexico? Well, the media doesn't seem to, or at least they're trying their hardest to forget. I'm Anders Hagstrom, and these are the facts. CNN wrote a puff piece about the family this week, and here's the headline. New Mexico compound family struggled with life off the grid. Struggled with life off the grid? The guy let a three-year-old starve to death and was taking notes on the, quote, phases of a terrorist attack. Prosecutors say several of the kids overheard the five adults talking about jihad and martyrdom, and that they were training these children to go into public spaces and shoot people in the name of radical Islam. But CNN says what's really newsworthy here is how hard it was for this family to survive in rural New Mexico, and how their case might foster Islamophobia. Whenever radical Islam is involved, CNN simply refuses to give anything but the absolute minimum of coverage.
But you might have been able to save a child if he was still alive.
Yeah, thanks for reminding me of that. It's not like it's hard enough to live every day wishing that I could have got there quicker. But you gotta get there lawfully.
Okay. I only have a couple more questions.
I think we're done.
I have just a couple more questions.
I think we're done.
I just really quickly asked to put that camera on. Is that not true?
We're done. Thank you. Have a great day.
Is that not true?
In the days after the arrests, CNN, Washington Post, and the New York Times all published pieces minimizing or outright ignoring the influence of radical Islam. Just imagine the coverage had the five adults been white Christian members of the KKK training kids to do the exact same evil things. What's even worse in this situation is that one of the men is the son of a prominent Muslim imam from Brooklyn, who is investigated but never indicted for assisting in the 1993 bombing of the World Trade Center. And what's more, the imam has been a longtime mentor to none other than Linda Sarsour, the Muslim feminist who started the Women's March.
What part of I don't want you to video record me?
We're doing an interview.
She herself has had to fight off accusations of anti-Semitism and sympathy with more radical factions within Islam.
You have fascists and white supremacists and Islamophobes reigning in the White House.
But to CNN, if you're going to call an apple, you need to call an Islamic extremist. And now let's go to some of your comments about Pope Francis. And Sant'Angelo says, time to drain the religious swamp. I think last time God drained the religious swamp, it went really badly for the vast majority of people. Waterboard the Pope? Problematic. Sherry Chestnut. There's no way that's a real name. Larry Vandermolen says, well, religion is only worshiping a little statue and getting tax breaks. Everybody roast Larry. Thanks for watching. Be sure to like us here at the DCNF Presents the Facts and our friends over at American Voices and the Daily Caller. Thanks for watching.